Well, here we are, everyone, at Jola Winery and Vineyards in Enpost Restaurant. We're going to show you how to make our new special, soon to be on the menu. It's a seared colossal sea scallop with some navy bean puree, Tuscan style. So here we have some navy beans. We're going to take half a can, so if you had just one can at home, it's obviously a lot smaller than this. You're going to take half. You want most of the fluid if you can. You put in your blender or food processor with some rosemary, dried, and some dried thyme, about half and half, a pinch each. And then what we're gonna do is add about 2 cloves of garlic per can that you'd have at home. So these are really large cloves, so each cut them in half. And that really represents 2 cloves right there. We already have the dried herbs. We're gonna add a couple of squirts of fresh lemon juice, like that, and a little salt, and a little pepper. What we're gonna do is just puree that really fast. And that's half of the navy bean puree. So what we'll do is we're going to add the navy beans to this so you have some consistency and textural differences. And this will actually reduce in the next clip, which will show to create a nice, almost mashed potato feel, but still have a lot of the texture of the whole beans. So here we have, just sauteing in some butter, some diced red onion. Red onion's really important for the color. And also it holds up a lot better with texture under heat. So we just salt and pepper to taste and a little bit of butter. We're gonna saute that up nicely. And then when we get that just kind of where we need it, which is translucent, we're gonna add equal parts sugar and red wine vinegar. So there's already natural sugars in this onion. So we're trying to caramelize that now. And we're gonna cook it down a little bit more with sugar, equal parts sugar, and then red wine vinegar. And we're gonna make what's called red onion jam. And that's gonna go on top of the scallops. So this will reduce slowly over low heat. You can see how low that heat is right there, because you'll burn all that sugar. So you gotta stay really with it and keep stirring it. Pay attention to it, and that'll all reduce, the fluid will all reduce. You'll end up with a texture that looks like this. So you can see this is a finished red onion jam and how jammy it looks and thick. So that's kind of the texture that you're looking for. So we're gonna finish this off now when that is done. And this will refrigerate for weeks, if not a month or more, because of the sugar and the vinegar content. So you can see that's already starting to get thick. And we're gonna come right back and we're gonna put the whole dish together. Right, here we are, back to finish up this beautiful scallop dish. So these are the nice colossal scallops. We took the abductor muscle off, which is like a little piece, usually right around here. You just peel that right off. And we're gonna salt it on both sides. And then pepper, both sides. We already have some butter melting in the pan. And what we're gonna do is, we're gonna start the scallops, and then we'll put them back on a separate pan so we don't cross-contaminate with cooked and raw. Proper scallops should be about medium rare, believe it or not. So get good, high quality scallops, you want to serve medium rare. Almost like a tuna steak. So here you have that red onion jam, still cooking down, nice and slow. So we have this scallop, and the secret in the restaurant business is to cook seafood, especially shellfish. You want to give it to a slow waiter and have them walk them through a hot kitchen. So in other words, high heat, short period of time. So what we're trying to do is get about a minute and a half on the first side, and then what we'll do is we're gonna flip it over. You can see we're getting some brownness in the butter. And here, if I flip it over, see the nice caramelization. And believe it or not, most of the times, one more minute on that side and it's done. Just let it sit, turn the heat down a little bit. The butter's getting nice and brown. You don't want it to burn completely. I'm actually gonna add a touch of olive oil to it right now. It'll help reduce that smoking point. Plus, we're gonna use this in the Tuscan bean puree. So here's the whole beans, and then here's the puree. We're gonna do about half and half. Just like that. And when we take those scallops off to rest on that new pan, because right now these are done, they're gonna continue to cook in what's called carryover temperature because of the heat. So believe it or not, they'll still kind of cook. See that nice caramelization there? Now in that same pan, with all that goodness, you get that puree. See how that's thickening up nicely? Get all the beautiful flavors from that brown butter, the scallops. Just want that to reduce a little bit. And those are still kind of cooking right there. And what we'll do is we'll take that puree. Nice, easy one pan cooking. If you could smell this, you'd want to buy 3-4 orders of this. Your guests are going to think you're a genius and say, how did you think to pair cannelloni beans, which is the Italian name for these, or navy beans, with scallops? You're a genius. So we're going to take the scallops now that we cooked, like that. See, it's kind of get the browns, a little bit of brown here and there, but now you're going to dress it up with some beautiful red onion jam, a little splash of color. And you think you're done, but you're not. It looks done, but it's all in the finishing touches. A little fresh lemon juice to brighten up the flavors. And a little bit of parsley. And a little Parmesan snow, which is some finely grated Parmesan cheese. Just a little bit. Help that navy bean. And there you have our Circe scallops with Tuscan herb navy beans and red onion jam. Bon appetit.